Hi folks, this is Moondan Nagavan. Today we are going to see Matplotlib session 3 on bar charts. Generally, bar charts stands for presenting the categorical data with the rectangular bars with heights or lengths proportional to the values that they present. For example, if it is a horizontal, it will be the heights. If it is a vertical, it will be the length. And we can plot in both ways. A gentle syntax for Matplotlib pyplot.bar looks like it will have x and height and width of the bar and bottom and align which alignment we want and data and keyword arguments. So next one we will go to the demo and see how it works. So before going to the demo, we will see what are the different values we can represent for the bar. So it will be the sequence of scalars and height we can mention and width, and we can mention the bottom. So scalar or array like optional. And we can mention two type of alignments, one is center, one is edge, that we will see in the demo. And remaining thing, it will return the bar container. It will have entire the data representation in the bar chart. And other parameters like color, edge color, line width, tick label, X error, Y error. So other different kind of other optional inputs available in the form of keyword arguments. So let's go into the Jupyter. Here, as usual, the first line starts like matplotlib.pyplot as PLT. So we are getting the utility as a PLT. And we have the x-axis values, let's say different languages name, Python, C++, Java, Perl, Scala, Lisp. And we are giving the different values assigned to that. So that will be like 10, 8, 6, 4, 2, 1 respectively. Here we need to make sure that length of object should be equal to the performance length. So that means the number of inputs in both arrays should be same. And next line will be plt.bar, and we are giving the x values. So x values will be the Python, and performance will be the y values or the height. And after that, alignment center, and alpha is equal to 0.5 width, and color I am giving as a blue here, and label I am giving as a usage, because if you give the label, then it will be easy to make the legend for that. And as usual, we are giving the y label and title for that chart, and I am going to display that one. So shift enter, you can see the things. And we have seen align as edge also. We are going to see edge how it will be. Because if you see the namings here, so Python, C++, Java, the names will come in center of the bar chart, right? So if you mention edge, it will be in the start. Shift enter. So you can see at the starting point, you can see the names of the objects. And legend show the data representation, which color represent what. If you want to change the color, you can change it. Shift enter. So it will change the color as well. So it's a very basic bar chart. Even if you want to do a different kind of extra parameters, you can add to that. And one more thing, here it is a vertical bar. So if you want to have a horizontal bar, just the same thing, but you need to have H here. So bar H means bar horizontal. So let's enter. So you will see the same graph in the horizontal way. So whatever most of the things available in the bar chart, it will be available for the bar horizontal as well. But the only difference is it will be in the horizontal. So this is all about bar chart. So thanks all. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.